Welcome back. I am Professor Harsha Gangavani from BCC department from GS College of Commerce, Vardha. And you know, I am going to teach you the visualbasic.net for BCC Part 3, same site. So, I already given you the tutorial about the introduction of visualbasic.net, introduction of .net framework. And some components of .NET framework I already discussed with you. I already given the particular, we can say the difference between DOS-based programming and Windows-based programming. I already told you about the features of Visual Basic. Now, this tutorial means today's tutorial is depending upon creating a simple application with the help of .NET Framework IDE. Before that, we have to install the Visual Basic .NET Framework. I already give the particular one video for it, how we can install the Visual Basic .NET. Okay. So, this tutorial is depending upon the Visual Basic .NET IDE and creating a simple application. It is a combination of these two topics because I am creating simple application with the help of Visual Basic .NET IDE. So, when we click on or when we select or when we open the Visual Studio 2010, then these first windows will appear on the screen. We have to create, click on the new project here. When we click on new project, then the next window, that is this window will appear. You can see some features which is provided by the .NET framework. Means we can create such type of the programming in one platform. Okay, Visual Basic, Window, Wave, Office, Cloud, Reporting. So basically we can create in your HTML syllabus Visual Basic .NET framework having two types of programming, like console based programming and Windows based programming. So I select here window. Okay. So basically this is nothing but the platform we choose. After choosing this platform, we create such type of the programming. So, Visual Basic window providing such platform we create for the creation of programming. Okay. So, we have to choose a Windows form application if we want to create the window application, or we have to choose the console application if we want to create the console application. I already told you the Visual Basic programming or practical of Visual Basic .NET is divided into two parts, console application and Windows application. So we have to create two type of programming in same platform. So here I choose the Windows form application. We can give the name of this window application. We can choose the location where we want to store our projects. Okay. The solution name, it is nothing but the name of the project. Then we click on the OK, the next window will appear, that is nothing but the IDE of Visual.NET Framework. So, in previous slide, I forgot one thing, that is the .NET Framework. This is nothing but the compiler which we use for compilation of our program. It will provide such type of compiler in your framework, means which is used for compilation. So, after clicking OK, this window, this IDE will appear. This IDE, you already know about the VB and IDE. IDE means what? IDE is nothing but the Integrated Development Environment. Integrated means what? Combination. Combination means we having some combinational part. Okay. Designing, which is used for designing. Environment. Environment means one location, one format. So basically we integrated some part which is used for designing the window based application in one screen or one platform. This is nothing but the IDE, and you aware about that IDE because you having the subject Visual Basic in your semester 3. Okay. So basically this IDE having some component, which are which component they have? It having a menu bar. Okay, this is the menu bar. Menu bar, then toolbar, which having some particular shortcut keys of the menus. Menu bar providing us the menus with its item. Then this is the toolbox. This is the floating toolbox. You can place here to there here. Okay, this provide us the tools. Tools means control. This toolbox provide us the control, which is provided by the Visual Basic. We can simply drag and drop those particular tool or control on the form and create the application. This is the Solution Explorer. You remember very first window asked us about the solution, name of the solution. Okay, the name of the solution is nothing but the project, and this is the Solution Explorer Windows application. See, I can't change the name of the project, so it shows the Windows application. Then so how many particular forms are collected, or how many forms are belonging this application, Windows application? See, those all forms or information all about all forms are displayed here. This is nothing but the Solution Explorer. Okay. Then this is the property window. This is the property window, which is shows the properties of the control which is selected by you. Okay. Here I just drag and drop the button. This is the button control on the form. Just drag and drop this particular button and just change the property of this button text as red color. Okay, when I select this particular button and goes on property window, then it will shows the properties of all properties of this control. Okay, then I can choose or I can change, I can select the some properties from this property window, and after changing the property, this is nothing but the design time coding, we can say, we changing the property of this particular button. Then I have to write the code for application. As you know, the particular Visual Basic has the event driven programming language. Yes, event driven means when we click on some button, or when we select some particular option, or when we produce or scroll the particular scroll bar, or we can performing some event like click, double click and scroll. When we select, click, scroll, the particular control provide some event that particular form or that particular control, then it can run the procedure. So that it can run the procedure, that means if I click on button, then it will produce the output. So after clicking, the particular event will perform. That's why it is called as event driven programming. After clicking, it will perform. Okay, so particular event driven programming having some control, where whenever or however you click on that particular button, it will perform this particular procedure again and again. So in VB, we just use the private sub command. It is nothing but the button one. Now in VB, VB.net, it provide us some that type of the programming, or that type of the, we can say, the template of the coding. So the very first programming code, that is public class form 1. We can't change the name of the form, that's why it shows the class form 1. It create a class. I already told you the Visual Basic .NET is object oriented programming, having the concept of object oriented. So all the features of object oriented programming is provided in Visual Basic .NET. So it create a class of that particular form. Then private sub button 1, this is the name of the button, _click is the event, and this event having two parameters, like by while sender as a system dot object and by while e as a system and event argument. Now event args and system dot objects, that means object and event are the classes of the .NET framework. I already told about this particular .NET framework having the huge library in my previous video. Okay, so this is the particular button click event which having two arguments and return some click. Okay, so I write here the me. What is me? Me, it is nothing but the object of the current form. Okay, so me dot backColor. BackColor, it is a property and I set it this property at runtime equals to color dot red. Okay, when I run it, the following procedure that will be happen here. That means the our particular compiler will run the code, execute the code, find out the error. If there is no error, then it will goes on the execute cycle, code 0 0 into 0. So after that I click here, then this window will run. Means after clicking this red color, it will give us the red color. Okay, color red means change the background color of the form. Okay, this is about the simple application which is I created in our Visual Studio .NET framework. The further means I am just changing the property of particular control at design time as well as the runtime. After giving some tutorial about the data types and all functioning, we just do the complex programming in our Visual Studio .NET framework. So thank you guys. Keep watching my next video.